Yo, what up guys, it's Flark, and welcome to my Shadowlands Season 4 Top 5 Best Comps list. I think you guys are going to agree with this one, actually. I pretty much just took the best specs that I thought going into this season and then gave them a comp that would perfectly fit into the meta that I foresee for Shadowlands Season 4. So these are going to be some really powerhouse comps here, and if you want to get high rated really quickly, just play any of these. But no need for an intro, right? This is very obvious what's going on here. Best five comps of the new season. Here we go. First, starting off with number 5, DK Demo. This is easily one of the best comps last season. And while it did get a tiny bit of nerfs, Demo didn't get that hit hard, and Unholy didn't get hit that hard. But more importantly, the things that they do well into got buffed. Unholy Demo does fantastic into casters and really just hated Rat Warrior, which is less prominent than it used to be. As a result, Unholy, DK, and Demo will still do a great job sustaining people down. The higher health pools are going to be great with DK's self-healing, Demo's self-healing from Soul Leech. They should be tankier and their sustain should be just as good. A-Bomb Limb got a little bit of nerf, but the sustain didn't, and there's constant damage that was generally how they would win. While they desynced their cooldowns and threw a limb at you, then an Unholy Assault at you, then a Tyrant at you, and just, oh my god, eventually we don't have any answers for this. Wow, they have spammable CC, 2 instant stuns from the Demo, 1 instant stun from the DK, and a Strangulate on top of that with Fears and possibly Howl, maybe Shadow Fury, and then whatever your healer brings to the table. I really think you could be seeing this with Aur Shaman this season. Of course, Holy Priest not nearly as good now, but Aur Shaman, maybe even Aur Druid, could absolutely take that place, and the comp could just skyrocket right back up to the top 5, even with some of the nerfs to the original way that comp was played, DK Demo Holy Priest. So look out for that. Try it with an Aur Druid or an Aur Shaman. You still got that purge if you play with an Aur Shaman, and you've got pretty decent Rake clone or Incap clone from an Aur Druid. Try it with those healers, and I think you're still going to have a fantastic comp. DK Demo, one of the most oppressive comps in the game, and probably sticking that way for another season. Number 5. Number 4, we have RMP. I know. That is the lowest that this comp will ever be on one of these lists. Maybe I'm crazy, but while I do think RMP will always be good, I don't necessarily think it will always be the absolute best comp. For example, I keep talking in all my videos about how sustain, rot, higher health pools are all going to be featured way more from this Shadowlands Season 4. Well, those are all good answers for RMP, especially with some of the RMP nerfs, Holy Priest nerfs, and now they'll play it with Disc. That comp is very susceptible to getting rotted down. Fire Mage is less tanky. Rogues were already dying. Disc Priest is even a kill target. I mean, these specs are squishy now. And while RMP will always find a way to be good because they can triple CC your entire team and then kill you, the problem with RMP in prior seasons is that it could do that. And it was also like one of the tankiest comps in the game, with Outlaw and Fire Mage doing 800k healing and the Holy Priest having 55,000 outs. That's why RMP was better than the best comp. It was like comp number 0 on this list. But finally, through changes to the meta and a ton of nerfs going into these specs, I finally think RMP is brought way down. And while the 4th best comp in the game still is a very good comp, and I still think it could even be, I mean, DK Demo beats it, but overall, maybe RMP has more winning matchups. That's hard to say. It could be number 5 on this list. That's still a huge fall from grace from being the only comp played at AWC at all, effectively. So RMP, number 4, that should be a huge sigh of relief for most players, except for players who play RMP. But don't worry, you're still playing RMP, so you should be okay. Number 3, S-Play. I would have rated this higher because I am so certain this comp is going to be destructively overpowered. But coming from like off a top 5 list, like maybe 10 or 15, all the way up to number 2 or 1, seems a little bit too overreacting, right? The reason I think it's going to be so good is because Aflok got buffed, health pools. How many times do I have to say it, right? I mean, we're talking the same thing every time, but that's what the meta looks like right now. Tons of sustained pressure, unhealable rot, staying alive with those massive health pools and the Dark Pact and the self-healing and the Shadow Priest can live a lot better now, and Ret Warriors are less popular, and Ret Warrior does a lot less burst anyway because Ret got a big 7-8% damage nerf during Wings, and you've got a much better comp. I mean, the only reason I think this comp wasn't played last season is because Espriest just died. And it still can die, but at least it's not going to be dying to every team that queues into it because, again, Ret Warrior should be a lot less prominent. So Esplay feels like it has the entire toolkit. And remember, Shadow Priest toolkit is awesome. It was just dying, so it couldn't use it. But stun silence on a healer while they're taking VT, Devouring Plague, Shadow Word Pain, Unstable Affliction recently buffed, Corruption recently buffed, Agony recently buffed. Like, all of that damage on all of their team, and the healer's an instant CC, and fears sometimes don't even break it. I mean, you can just CC their entire team while killing them all at the same time. This is a great comp, and it has been insanely good throughout the entire history of World of Warcraft PvP. So if there was ever a time for it to surge back up to the top comps in the game, it's right now after the buffs and the change of meta. So look out, guys. Oh, and by the way, the Shadow Priest can PI the Aflock. So Dark Soul Misery being nerfed from 30 to 20 isn't going to matter when they have PI and Dark Soul. I mean, that's just going to be a big suck that wipes out your entire team. And in about 7 weeks, we're going to be geared, right? So in 7 weeks, tell me if you're sick of queuing into S play. I'll wait. Moving on to number two, Turbo. Yeah, I think that's just inarguable. This comp is going to be insane this season. It was already insane last season, and it probably just got better. Fury Warrior gets more self-healing from the higher health pools, and Enhance survives better with the higher health pools, and they crush Warlocks. If anything is going to stop Warlock from being the most dominant force, look no further than Turbo. They have Shear, Short Cooldown, Tremor, Grounding, Self-Healing, Hard to Peel, Sustained Damage. Unlike DK, where you A-bomb Limb and then they gateway it, and then you're like, oh crap, I'm out of luck. Turbo just gets back to you, keeps doing damage. Then you port back. Nope, they're back on you. They keep doing damage. Okay, well, maybe I'll Knife Fade. Nope, they just charge you, keep doing damage. Turbo is very difficult to disrupt. They have never-ending single-target damage. They all support each other perfectly. Play with an Ardruid, play with a Disc Priest even. You can keep your teammates alive with a hybrid, and then the Intervene and the Rally and the Off-Healing and the Chain Harvests, right? And if there's no good kill target for very long until dampening, and they're the ultimate dampening comp because they just keep grinding you out of cooldowns, then it's very, very difficult to find a way to actually win into this comp. And even CC, that feels a little low because they just have Stormbolt, Fear, maybe the Shaman goes for Hexes, that can be very disruptive. But then you just supplement that with Ardruid, who has Clone. So they have CC too. It's like it's very difficult to find a weakness on Turbo right now. Hard to kill. Hard to peel, hard to heal through their damage, hard to get out of CC sometimes, and a long range Shear plus Grounding plus Tremor. They've got the utility, the damage profile, all of the toolkit to be completely nauseating to deal with. One of the best comps last season, getting better this season. Of course, it's getting the number two spot. So what could possibly be better than this? Look no further than number one spot, Jungle. Duh. Of course it is. It was probably the best comp in the game last season if Turbo wasn't, and it just got better, and it probably got even better than Turbo got better. It's the perfect comp for this meta. Never-ending damage. Can perfectly peel all your goes. Kite around a pillar, self-healing, frenzied regeneration. The hunter gets peeled by the druid who gets peeled, who perfectly can peel the priest. Disc is going to snowball this comp so well. I mean, it's just a nightmare to deal with this. They never stop killing you, ever. Imagine queuing into a comp where their win condition is to do maximum uptime damage on you while running around a pillar. You have no counter pressure for them, and they're still killing you the entire time. The only time the Feral dies is in stuns out of form, but because his kiting and self-healing is so good, the priest will probably have a cooldown for him in that stun out of form, right? Paints up, grip, barrier, just a couple of radiance charges, rapture. The BM hunter never, ever stops doing damage to you. So it's really on the Feral to go in, maim, kill you, run. Go in, maim, kill you, run. They got stun trap. They got clone. They got fear. They have a perfect CC toolkit that doesn't DR with each other. They have a fantastic profile for getting damage out while staying alive and CCing your entire team. Nobody on your team can do everything, anything, and everybody on their team can do everything. That is how jungle played all last season, and it's probably just better now. They're going to be even harder to kill, but they're still going to be just as hard to live against. And that is, my friends, why jungle is going to be the most nauseating comp in Shadowlands Season 4. And I urge you, if you don't believe me, check back in 8 weeks and comment down on this video. Okay, fine, I'm sick of queuing into jungle. But there we go. That's my list. Really, though, if there is anything you disagree with, let me know. There's so many amazing comps that I wasn't able to put on this list because I only said five. There's more than five good comps in the game. So what do you think? Where's another comp that you guys want to put in the comment section below of what could be really, really, really good this season? I can't wait to hear it, but I'll read every single one. We'll have a good discussion. We'll get ready for Shadowlands Season 4, the last thing before Dragonflight comes and hopefully saves us all. See you guys in the next one. Peace.